trapped in the fortress of distortion. I'm at war with my emotions. I'm at war with the enforcement. Trying to fight for what's right and got sidetracked. Where your mind at? Never mind that. Can't be thinking to blink. You swimming, you sinking. You winning, you leaving the heaven. I loaded my weapon. I stay with my brethren, I pray for protection. My prayer in my sight, so I'm doing what's right and not asking no questions. I wanna be home free, where's one that was lonely? But I'm ready and waiting for my day of salvation, and I'm patient.
I'm gonna do a little bit of a review video on the Circus Expert fork. As you can see behind me here, this is a Commencal Absolut, size large. I got secondhand about 4 months ago. Well, a little longer than that now, but I had ridden it for about 4 months. Currently it's January, it's 20 degrees, there's tons of snow, so I'm not outside riding skate park. It's more of a fat bike time of year. But I ran into a problem with the Circus, and that prompted me to make this video, as well as to provide my thoughts and a little bit of a review of the Circus Expert fork. So here is the Circus Expert. This is what came with the Absolut. I thought this was a good feeling fork. I liked the way it felt. It was stiff. Sturdy, it feels sturdy, feels good quality. The clicks on it are very prominent. They feel nice. You know if it's locked out and then two clicks, that's how I typically would ride it. But you could ride it all the way locked out, and it was the best lockout of any fork I'd ever ridden. I mean, it really felt good locked out. It would give a little bit on the landing of a jump, but that's about it. And I think it's supposed to. It's supposed to give just a little bit so it doesn't damage the lockout. The fork did have a problem right away. I put the max amount of air that I could put in it so it would ride really stiff. And it had some top out issues where it would make a little bit of a clunk. And so on the bottom here, I just slowed down the damper and that fixed that. No more clunk. So if you're having a clunk with the Circus Expert fork, just slow the rebound a little bit and the clunk should go away. As far as this reverse arch, one of the biggest questions, one of the main reasons I never bought this fork is because one of my favorite tricks is a foot jam. I love doing foot jams. They're low risk and I can just do them on various things, quarter pipes or wedges or whatever. And I'd always wondered if you could foot jam this reverse arch. And it turns out you can. And pretty good too. It's not too bad. It took me about a month to get somewhat comfortable foot jamming again with the reverse arch to where I could do it almost every try. I never quite felt as comfortable as when the arch was on this side. That 3-4 inch difference in balance point and just being able to stick my whole shoe on the top of the tire. Here it has a little bit more BMX feel where it's like just your toe kind of in there. You don't have as much of a platform to balance on, but it works. It works well. So if you're wondering, should I buy a Manitou? And can I do foot jams if you did buy a Manitou? The answer to that question is yes. Yes, you can. And it just takes a little extra time if you're used to it from here. Why is this fork not on my bike, you might be asking? Well, because I broke it. Well, not broke it. I twisted it. I went off a jump and did a whip. Ooh. Went off a jump and just went to do a whip and then bring it back, except I never brought it back. I just kind of went sideways and then threw the bike down and my body weight landed on the bike and the fork, my body kind of landed on the fork like that at an angle, and I couldn't get my handlebars straight. I thought maybe I bent my handlebars, and then I realized that the fork itself was twisted, and when I would look down, you know, this side would be sitting higher than this side. And so then I started inspecting the fork, and I found that some of the paint had chipped off here, along there, right there, and a little bit right here. And so this bridge bent, it twisted. And that happened on a Saturday. So Saturday night, I sent a message to Manitou, and I let them know of my situation. I had this gently used bike before I got it, so that it was basically a new fork. And I had ridden it for 4 months, and it had already bent. It was a crash that I bent it on, not just doing normal riding. And they promptly, Sunday morning, when I woke up, there was already an email in my in-basket that said, here's a 40% off your next Manitou fork purchase. You know, they gave a month and a half to buy a new fork. And I was very impressed. I mean, that's amazing customer service. I didn't have a receipt. I didn't buy the bike new, and they still offered a 40% discount. So if you're in the market for a new fork and you're considering a Manitou, amazing customer service. It actually is a pretty good feeling fork. I prefer the front arch for foot jams, and but other than that, I wouldn't hesitate to get one if this is something. It's relatively inexpensive, the Expert here. I probably would go with the next level up, the Pro, given that this one bent. But yeah, that's for another day. I'm gonna make another video here after this where I will be unboxing my new fork, and you'll see what it is. Then putting it on here, and I'm gonna try to fit a gyro on this thing, Odyssey gyro, see how that works. Anyway, if you have any questions about the Circus Expert, if anything was unclear, or I will get back to you in the comments below and try to provide the best answer I can. It's a good fork, you know, it's a decent fork. It's too bad it bent. Let's see what my new fork looks like though. I'm excited. New parts are always nice. Thanks for watching.